Meanwhile, critical race theory now coming for your health care. Instructors at Harvard Medical School calling to use race as a determining factor when treating patients for heart failure. In their anti-racist agenda for medicine, they will argue, quote, we call this a vision for medical restitution. Federally paid reparations, urgent and long overdue, would help to mitigate racial health inequities. Author Douglas Murray, we're calling on you again. Harvard calling out Harvard.
It's unbelievable, except for anyone who's followed what critical race theory is trying to do and the extent which it is just running through America, every single facet of America. It is quite amazing to look at what these Harvard professionals have been arguing for. They say race should be a determining factor in how American heart patients are treated. And it says, wait for this, that there should be a preferential admission option for Black and Latinx patients. I mean, you have to just pause for a moment and think, imagine how outraged we would all rightly be if some Harvard professional said, you know, there should be a preferential treatment for heart failure patients for people who are white. I mean, we would be outraged. And here are these medical professionals saying that there should be a preferential treatment for black and other minority groups. It's absolutely despicable, but this is the absolutely logical endpoint of this illogical worldview.
Douglas, they say that they noted that white patients in the past have been more likely to be admitted to cardiology when they have heart issues as opposed to patients of color, Black and Latino patients with the same cardiac issues. That's what they claim.
You know, I'm afraid it doesn't hold much water because we've seen too much of a pattern of this in the last year. There's just been a publication from the American Medical Association, which argues some very similar things. We saw the Center for Disease Control last year, the height of the COVID pandemic, talking about preferential racial treatment depending on racial grouping. This is a pattern across America. We've seen it in other cities. We saw it recently in Boston. It's a pattern across America, and it is BLM medicine. We've seen what BLM does when it's in control of education. We've seen what it does when it's in control of corporate policy. This is what BLM looks like when it's got control of the medical world.
And I just think it's amazing that the New York Times yesterday does a big story how the Republicans have found an issue, a culture issue, to push back on critical race theory. Not found an issue. They want to keep the curriculum they have. They're not finding an issue. The issue found them.
Yeah, what these people are all doing at the moment is, on the one hand, using critical race theory and other divisive racist measures to divide Americans. And then when anyone on the right calls it out, they say it doesn't really exist, or the right has sort of invented it. The right didn't invent this idea. The right didn't decide to give preferential treatment to certain racial groups in America in the 21st century. This is a left-wing idea. It was developed in left-wing universities and rubbishy social science departments, but it's been able to rush across the entire country. And when America is at the state that medical professionals across the country are talking about giving preferential treatment to people depending on their racial grouping, this should be the moment we say, right, you have crossed the line as far as you should be allowed to cross it. And we've got to stop them right here.
So you got to hit the Ivy League schools big time. Now they got to justify themselves to themselves. Amazing.
And to the taxpayer and to the American taxpayer.
Absolutely, Douglas. I appreciate it. Talk to you again soon.
It's a great pleasure.
Always makes sense.